Oof.
Oh, you hit. That sounded hard.
It was fairly hard.
Let me say hi for my video. We're gonna go kill the dragon. And hang on a sec. Stupid portal so loud. Okay. So, the dragon's already been killed in this world, as you know. So it's not exactly like, you know, like if you were to go in the first time. Things should be substantially easier than if this were the first time we were going in. And there's two of us, which should help. And the reason that we're doing this is because I added the command block so that the dragon drops an elytra when it's killed. And I've tested it, and it does indeed work. And so I have an elytra for myself. And they're a bunch of fun, so I figured you probably want one too.
Heck yeah, I'm ready to fly.
So, let's go into the end. So, I don't know how much you've been in here. Oh, I need to go over and light that area up.
That's... Yeah, I actually came out facing those Endermen with my cursor right over one.
Yeah.
It is an aggro.
Yeah, fortunately they changed it, so you pretty much have to look them in the eyes for them to... Oh, somebody's a little PO'd. So you have to pretty much look them in the face now. But, okay, so End Island is lit up pretty darn well. Let me do this real quick. Ender chest. So, I have some end crystals, which we need. Come on, pick up. And I'll put in on the bar here. So, the way this works, so we go over to the exit portal here, and I will place end crystals, 4 end crystals around the portal. And, and just so everyone's aware, the reason I added the dragon drop command block is because, and you and I have talked about this, come to the conclusion that the way the end loot, especially the elytra and the shulker boxes, are balanced is very much not balanced for multiplayer servers. The end cities are kind of ridiculously rare, and the end ships are especially so. So I think in the interest of everyone having fun on the server, getting the elytra from a dragon fight isn't a bad way to go. Because it's a challenging, difficult thing. So it's not like we're just cheating them in. So I think it's a good solution. So what's going to happen when I put the end crystals around the portal, one on each of the long sides, right? 1, 2, 3, 4. What's going to happen is the portal will deactivate. Beams of light will shine up in the sky. And then they'll start going out to the tops of each of these obsidian pillars. And the end crystals that were on top of the obsidian pillars will respawn.
Okay.
And each one, it'll explode. And I think the first one to respawn will be this one over here, where there are some Endermen on top. It'll be either that one or the one to the right of it. And then you notice the 1, 2 over to the right of that, the one where I have the torches on the side. There's iron bars up there. And then one across the other way has iron bars on it. So the end crystals will spawn one at a time. And then on those two, they'll be surrounded by iron bars, which is a little bit trickier. So Then after all the end crystals are restored, then the dragon will actually show up and start flying around. There are a few Endermen around, but because of the lighting, there's not a lot. And those Endermen will come down and they'll start going after the dragon. And if you happen to be between the dragon and them, it'll look like they're coming for you, but they're not. Because they really hate the dragon. So the dragon will kill them, and the dragon will try to kill you. So the dragon will fly around.
It's a ranged attack, I assume?
Yeah, he shoots fireballs.
Okay.
And just like the ghast, he shoots the fireballs at where you are, not where you're going. So if you keep moving, the fireballs are not going to be a problem.
Cool.
Where the fireballs hit on the ground, it does knock out torches. It also spreads dragon's breath, which if you stay in it, will hurt you. Not a lot, but just a little bit. It's like poison. So
is a visible area of effect on the ground, I assume?
Yeah, there's particles. You'll see it. So stay out of that stuff. Or if you find yourself just taking damage for no obvious reason, look down because you're probably standing in some dragon's breath.
Okay.
And if I had thought about it, I should have brought some empty bottles because you can collect the dragon's breath. But and then the dragon will fly around. The dragon will try and swoop at you. If the dragon hits you, or me, just the player in general, can knock you up in the air, potentially knocking you off to the side as well. Worst case scenario is the dragon then tries to knock you off the edge of the island. That's bad. So you want to make sure that you can get to your ender pearls so that you can throw it back up to the island. And then periodically the dragon will fly in and sit on top of the portal. So when he's flying around, you can shoot arrows at him. When he's sitting on the portal, you can't. The arrows will just bounce off. But the thing is, as long as there's end crystals left, he's just gonna recover health anyway. He's just gonna heal up. So there's no point in attacking him until we get rid of all the end crystals.
So, and the end crystals, we just have to shoot arrows at from down here.
Or yeah.
What's the plan?
And then the two that have the iron bars around them. You got to pillar up to you. So here's what I'm planning on doing. I'll put down this last one. It'll start going through the sequence. I'll go over to this pillar over here, which will be like the second one to regenerate. I will pillar up and take out the end crystal before the dragon actually respawns. So that one is down. This one over here. That one's tricky. So I'm going to have to do that one during the fight. So what you can do is just immediately start trying to take out the crystals on top of the pillars that aren't in the iron cages.
Got it. Just shoot them with arrows.
Just shoot them with arrows. This one here, insanely tricky because of how tall it is. Because it's hard to see the crystal up on top. So you kind of have to lob it up and over. It might be best to sort of start with that one. Unfortunately, I'm not going to get up high enough pillaring up to either of the two with the bars to actually do any better. So that's the tricky one. And that may be the one that, you know, either if you can deal with that one first, great. Otherwise, we'll then concentrate on it last.
Can we pillar up to it and take it out?
Yeah. So they explode when you break them. So if you're standing on top of it and you break it, it can kill you pretty quickly.
If we ladder up one of these and then have a higher vantage point at it.
That might help. The problem is the higher up you are, the easier it is for the dragon to hit you.
Okay.
Because he will try and swoop for you, and then you'll do, you know, you take more damage when you fall. Water bucket can be useful for breaking your fall. It's a little tricky, but if you're looking down and you do that, or if you ender pearl, it'll get you down on the ground, although you take damage based on the velocity that you're going when you ender pearl.
Okay.
So anyway, I'll put this one down. And then just you can watch the sequence and see the crystals start to regen. I'm going to try and break this one here right away. And then we'll just concentrate on breaking the crystals. Once they're all down, then when the dragon swoops in and sits on top of the portal, that's the best time to come in and attack him with melee. But you have to be, you want to avoid his face, his head, his tail, and his wings. So the best place to go in is like in between the tail and the wings from behind.
And he's immune to ranged at that point?
He's immune to arrows at that point.
Okay.
So it's, you know, it's all pain. You'll see. It's, and fortunately, because this is all lit up, the Endermen, there will be Endermen showing up because they'll, you can see there's a few of them at the top of some of the pillars. And they'll come down to join the fray. So just be careful. And if you find an Enderman is on you, you can just dump down water and stand in the water.
And that'll keep the Enderman away?
Yeah, they won't go into the water because they take damage. They'll stand at the edge of the water and just scream at you.
And is there any way we can make like a quick little escape hut that we can hide in for whatever reason? Or
you can hide from the Enderman. Unfortunately, when the dragon flies through any bricks that any blocks that aren't endstone, bedrock, or obsidian, they get destroyed.
Okay.
So if you build a like a stone brick hut, the dragon can fly through, hit you, and destroy your hut.
What if I made an obsidian hut?
If you, yeah, but then it'll take you forever to get out of it. In theory, that would work. The dragon could still fly through it and hit you. He just won't destroy the hut. It would keep the Enderman away from you, though. So, and then...
Yeah, I'm partially curious about the Enderman.
Yeah, there won't be too many of them. Some of these torches will get knocked out. And I don't think we'll have any spawns going on down here. It'll mostly be there are spots where the Endermen can spawn and they will run up to try and kill the dragon.
Okay.
So they should mostly be a non-factor.
Cool.
So, there we go. That's our little strategy. I'll probably trim that out from the video because it's better to just go show the fight. It should be pretty straightforward.
I just hope it lasts a little bit longer than I did against the Guardians.
Yeah, just if you keep moving, you'll be okay. You got the golden apples, so just keep an eye on your health and just keep eating. You got 32 apples. That should be plenty. You can just keep eating. The apples will give you absorption hearts as well. The one big scary risk is you getting knocked off the island into the void, and that's what your Ender Pearls are for. Last ditch Hail Mary trying to get the Ender Pearl back onto the island. So, okay, you ready?
As ready as I'll ever be.
Okay, here we go. And boom. And it should be starting. There we go. And the reason that I can pillar up and break these ones with iron bars is because if I go up till I hit my head, come on. Damn it. Why is this not working? There we go. Okay, I got one. Oh, and if you hit, yeah, good shot. Okay, I'm getting down now. There we go. Oh, dragon just, okay. So I'm going to wait till the dragon is sitting on the portal. And don't bother shooting at the dragon. Focus on the crystals. So I'm going to wait till he's at the portal, distracted. And I'll pillar up and get this one. Where? Okay. Come on. Woohoo! Okay, nice. Get down and eat.
I think one flew up.
Yeah, I just hit it. Okay, there we go. Okay, so now we just need to. There's one up here. And it's a little tricky trying to get the. What the heck? Did I? There we go. Okay, and as the dragon flies around, you can see the beams coming from the crystals that are still left. Whoa, what was that? I got hit by something. So you can then focus on, yeah, that one's going to be the tricky one. Ah, got it. Yeah. Okay. One more up here.
I'll try and get to where I have a shot at that
one. Yeah. It's another tricky one because it's so tall. Oh, got it. Okay. That might be all of them. Let me go. Come on. You can do it. Why are you not hitting the dragon? Oh. Whoa. Ooh, that hurt bad. Did you see how high I went up in the sky?
No.
I went pretty high up. Okay. Thank you, Feather Falling. Okay, yeah, so now it looks like the dragon's not healing. So, arrows at the dragon help. I really suck at hitting the dragon, though.
So the wings hit you, right?
Yeah, the wings, and the dragon will spin around and try to hit you with its mouth. So you see, we're doing pretty well here. Yeah, okay, we got all the crystals, that's for sure. Ooh. All right. Okay, so when the dragon dies, it goes up into the air and then starts its little...
Ooh, I got him.
...death scream. Nice. And then it'll drop the Elytra, and it'll drop it right over the portal. But the portal won't ignite right away. So the easiest thing to do is to hop in and grab the Elytra from the portal before it reignites. If you don't, we can get it later, but it'll end up on the spawn island. There we go. Keep an eye out for the Elytra. It's right there. It's right there. Awesome. There you go.
Heck yeah.
Okay. Grab some experience.
Well, I survived.
Yes. You killed your first dragon.
That was definitely intense.
Yeah.
I feel like I'm still having trouble with this MacBook doing the right click for arrows.
Oh, so yeah.
Rapid fire is a little challenging. With a mouse, I would have definitely probably landed about 20 or 30 more shots. But
yep. Okay, so now you see the these little gateways that appear out around the corner, out around the edge.
Yeah, it's got another one of them, right?
Yeah. Did it? And it should shoot off like a beacon effect. Did you see that happen?
I didn't notice it. No. I imagine it's probably one of the two over here.
Yeah, I think there's 20 that can eventually appear.
Okay.
And some of them...
Or just kind of randomly?
No, they're spaced evenly around. And then they project out about 1,000 blocks out away from the island to the outer islands.
Okay. Also, I didn't see any Endermen during that fight. I think we kind of lucked out.
Yeah, well, it's having, I've been working on going around and making sure I light up the little surrounding edge areas, the little cliff areas. So I'm sure that's helped, because like there's a guy down over here. If he had seen the dragon, he would have joined in. That, and the gateway, one of the gateways, like this one over here, is actually over void, which is super annoying. It's not this one. One of them either here or on the outside is literally over void.
So there's pretty much nothing you can get to when you're there.
It puts you on a solid block, the nearest solid block to the portal that it can. So is it this one here? Yeah, it's this one here. It's super nerve-wracking to come back and realize, oh wait, this one's over nothing. So I built the little endstone island up there, so that you have something to stand. Oh, the beacon just went. So you know how those work. You just throw an ender pearl into it.
Yeah.
And you have to, the ender pearl has to hit one of the bedrock blocks. It is possible to throw an ender pearl all the way through the gateway and out the other side. And if it doesn't hit anything, you won't go through the gateway. So anyway, that's it. We survived pretty unscathed.
Yeah, I only used one of the golden apples, so there's your 31 back.
Cool. Thank you. And you have the Elytra in your pocket?
I have it, yeah. I'm ready to try it out for the first time.
And yeah, just don't do it here.
Yeah. I'll fly off into the void.
Yeah. So basically every time we want to summon the dragon, we can get an Elytra. So if we can, if Barb's not busy next time, we can bring her in and have her fight the dragon.
Yeah. With three of us, it should go pretty easy if we're able to all fight at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. I think group dragon fights are definitely the way to go.
Yeah. It's a little less concentrated fire. He didn't really get too close to me with most of his shots.
Yeah.
But I also kept moving pretty much the whole time.
Yeah, and that's the key to avoiding the fireballs. And then the dragon's breath is just, you know, if you find yourself in it, you just step out.
Yeah, thankfully I never ended up in it, I don't believe. It went next to me at one point, but
right.
It's pretty visible fire, so I did not stand in it.
Yeah, it's easy to miss because you're looking up trying to shoot at the dragon.
Yeah, no, so that's definitely a challenge.
I was thinking, you have this big, huge castle, but you don't have a throne room.
I do not have a throne room.
Okay, so like if you wanted to say build an Elytra launcher here, where are you? Oh. One thing you can do? Do you have any rockets on you?
I do not.
Here, let me throw you a few here. And you may want to just jump off of things and glide a little bit before you get into the rockets. But our little spider web here.
Oh, cool.
So you can get into flying mode while you're falling in a spider web.
Doesn't seem to work for me.
Are you standing on the ground?
I'm still falling in the spiderweb.
Oh, hit the space bar so you go into your flight position.
Didn't seem to work.
And then look up. And then... You weren't in flight mode there. So watch what happens. Just watch me. So if I jump onto the spider webs and then I hit, now I'm flying, even though I'm still falling. Oh, I waited too long.
So do you have to aim up with the rocket? Is that how it works?
Yeah, the rocket boosts you in the direction that you're facing. But you have to be flying. You can't do it from there.
Well, I'm trying to see if I can do it from a standstill.
You're not going to be able to.
Why not?
Because it's too hard. If you have a block up, like on the stairs, you might be able to. There you go.
I wasn't even on the stairs.
Yeah, you were.
No, I wasn't.
Yeah, you were. I have footage.
Liar.
I have footage. I'm recording.
Lies. Oh my gosh, I'm on the top of my tower.
So now there's particles that stream out in your face, and they'll go for the duration of the rock of the firework.
How do I? Okay, I am flying. For a second there, I wasn't sure if I was actually flying or just falling really fast.
And if you want to, like, ditch a lot of speed when you get on top above something, you look up and just spin around.
Yeah.
And that'll really burn off all your speed. It's so weird watching you fly below.
This is pretty awesome, I gotta say.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. Here you come.
Oof.
Oh, you hit. That sounded hard.
It was fairly hard. Yeah, thankfully I didn't take too much damage.
Yeah.
But yeah, I do notice the Elytra definitely has a little bit of damage.
Yeah, so now if you look at, I don't know if you have the what do you call it? The durability tooltip turned on.
Yeah, I'm at 347 of 432. Sorry, 347 of 432.
Yeah. So I'm at 406. So the unbreaking definitely helps. I think you can repair the Elytra with leather. I think it's leather.
Well, mending will take care of it, right?
Yes. But it'll be more expensive to put the mending on when you have when it's got damage. And you'll see, even without the rockets, by tilting down a little bit to get a little bit of speed and then tilting up, you can maintain altitude pretty well over long periods of time. The angle that you're aiming at is kind of important.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm running out of rockets.
Yeah, I just ran out.
Oh, and you can fly underwater, too. Oops. Oh, shoot.
Oh, nice. I just made it to your place.
There you go.
That's awesome. That's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it is. And I'm now happy that I have basically, you know, my front porch is here. All I have to do is jump off and fly.
Yeah, I wonder if I could make it to my house without rockets. I don't think I could.
That might be a little tough. You could definitely make it to the community area, but...
Yeah. Well, I guess I'll go community portal and then... Actually, you know, while I'm at your place, I'll just go down and get the mending and...
Yeah.
Unbreaking for this bad boy.
It's like 15 emeralds, so... Oh. I think I've... Mending for 10. I think my mending guy wants 10 and...
Yeah, he's 10.
And the unbreaking is... The unbreaking guy's pretty cheap, too.
And he's full unbreaking... What is it?
Unbreaking 3.
Yeah, it's a shame you can't use them while also wearing your armor.
Yeah, and it would be nice... I don't know if they'll... actually do it, but it would be nice if future update they make some sort of craftable armored Elytra or something like that.
Yeah. Or who knows? Whoa, you got a slime in your hallway.
That goes through a slime chunk.
It's like a greeter. So see, now I just need to find the new location. For everybody. So let me grab my toolbox, which has my books in it. Only two of those bad boys.
I think the mending guy is definitely on the bottom floor. He might be in the fourth, the second set of stalls.
Okay.
Let's see here. Yeah, so what would be kind of mean would be to put cursive binding on... yeah, actually, they're both right over here. So the mending guy wants 10. I'm breaking 3 wants 27. Which isn't super cheap, but it's not too bad.
Oh, yeah. With all the emeralds I have from all the trading I've been doing.
And I'm up to 5 iron golems.
Jeez.
Oh, 6. Nope, I've got 6. Yep, good 1, God. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ugh.
That is a little on the ridiculous side.
Well, it's going to make it difficult to extract some of these guys, because they got a full 19 villagers. I got 2 white coats. Let's see what they are.
Ooh, hopefully something good.
This guy's a cartographer.
Don't need any more of those.
No, the one we have is almost useless as it is. Actually, I only have 1 white coat. Okay, well, I'll have to spend some time managing the villagers, but... Yeah, so... Gosh, these guys are noisy.
They really are. That's one of the things I don't miss about my big villager breeding exercises was hours upon hours spent listening to them groan.
Yeah.
They're quite vocal.
And one cute thing that I found is occasionally I'll get a slime spawns out here somewhere. I'm not sure which of these is a slime chunk. And they'll pop up and jump on the pressure plate that activates the zombie spawner. So every now and then I'll walk by and I'll have zombies in the zombie spawner.
That's hilarious.
Yeah.
Well, you can make it a stone pressure plate. Oh, no, that's right. They still go for it. Yeah, never mind.
Yeah. I could make it a weighted pressure plate, and that might prevent it, but with only 1 slime, it would take more slimes, but anyway. I'm going to sleep here because my spawn point is over at the stronghold.
Oh, did your anvil break?
It's broken a couple times. Replacing all my gear, or getting my backup gear box... was pretty expensive. Oh goodness, so it broke again. What, it's already damaged.
Well, no, this is my new one. I just dropped it there for you.
Right, but it's already got damage on it.
Well, yeah, you want a brand new one?
Oh, I thought you put down a new one.
Yeah, well, I put down one that I had in my ender chest.
Oh, okay, but you've been using it.
Yeah, no, okay. It's one of my tools.
Okay, no.
So I'll just leave it here, and I'll make myself a new one.
Yeah, yeah, that's fine. I'll probably get enough from killing all the iron golems to make a new anvil anyway.
Let's see what else do I need. Okay, I got those guys, so I need to heal that. So I've been doing a lot of horse breeding and gathering up more horses around the community area.
Uh-huh.
And I have a couple pretty good horses right now. I have one that can jump 4 blocks.
Okay.
So the max, I think, is somewhere in the area of 5. But the highest I've been able to get so far is a full 4 blocks.
Okay.
But that 4-block horse is slow, and I'm trying to breed him with my 16 speed super fast horse that can't jump. Hopefully at some point get the best of both, but
yeah, hopefully you don't end up with a slow horse that can't jump.
Exactly. Which I've had a few of, which is kind of hilarious. And you have a horse that's slower than the walking speed. not exactly very fun.
Yeah,
cool. I'm gonna head off to the gold farm then.
All right,
mend this Elytra, and then make a bunch of rockets and try not to kill myself.
Yeah, have fun.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to flying around a bit.
Yeah, it's super cool. Oh, you should go up the other ladder.
Oh, yeah? I picked the wrong one?
Well, that's the old one. The other ladder is a straight shot all the way up.
Which one?
You don't have to transfer.
Where's the other ladder? Oh, the one to the left?
Yeah.
Okay, I see it. Need an elevator.
Yeah. Cool. Well, have fun.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll definitely enjoy being able to fly around now and make a bunch of rockets and see what I can do.
Yep. Oh,
yeah, this is a straight line. Nice.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to take down the other ladder at some point here, but cool. Okay, well, I'm going to disconnect from the voice chat because my internet is starting to suck.
Yeah, no worries.
So,
I'll cool. See you on the next chat.
All right. Bye.
Bye.